Anything there?
Coach, you made the Ohio road trip last weekend down at Ashland, top-ranked team in the GLIAC. Talk about that contest. You guys hung tough.
Yeah, I thought, Ashland's really good. I mean, they are talented. They don't have a lot of weaknesses. They defend. They rebound well. They have some really good go-to players that allow their role players to do what they do best, hit open shots, and they run it down your throat if you don't get back in transition. So going in, we were pretty focused on, having to stop their two main kids and getting back in transition, trying to make them work. And in the first half, I thought we did a really good job in our zone. When we were in the zone, it took them some time to get a shot, and we were able to rebound pretty well. We just struggled when we missed some easy looks that they were able to transition on us. And I think at the half we were down 12, so it was pretty manageable. I thought that was pretty good. Second half, I think they maybe wore us down a tad. They got us down 18, and we cut it back to 8. And then, their talent kind of took over. They were able to kind of settle themselves down and make a few baskets where we just couldn't connect. But overall, I thought, we gave great effort. You could see a change in the players and the way they competed. And, that was a game that really could have got out of hand when it got to 18. But I was proud that we were able to cut that back to 8 and really just kind of get better on that day.
Saturday against Lake Erie, a low-scoring contest.
Yeah.
Talk about that game.
Well, Lake Erie plays such a crazy style. They trap everywhere. They full court press. They really try to speed you up. And obviously, it was a contrast in styles. We want to play slow. We want to slow things down and play a zone and make people really have to use the shot clock. And then we use the shot clock as well. When a team presses you, it gets a little hard to slow down sometimes. Sometimes you have to attack that and try to get some easy baskets. Obviously. Our pace of play kind of won out in that it was low scoring. We just weren't able to score enough. So we were playing shorthanded. We only played with 7. We didn't have any point guards. It's not an ideal situation to go into a game like that where they're going to press you and trap you all over the place and not have a point guard. But I felt, we handled it the best that we could. The full court pressure did not hurt us, and we were able to have a lead in the first half. It's just, we went, I think, almost 9 minutes without scoring in the second half. And, you're not going to win too many games. So the fact that we were even within, 12 to 15 at that point was pretty impressive that we were able defensively to hold them down. And, that's a team that's averaging 70-something points a game, and we held them to 44 on their home floor. And, I think our defense is kind of coming around. We just really got to work on our offense now.
Talk about the defense you guys are playing, holding teams to well below their averages, especially Grace having a big season, top 5 in the nation in blocks.
Yeah, we're playing a lot of 2-3 zone. I'm typically not a zone coach. I haven't played a lot of it in the past. Just I feel it's with only having 8 kids, it's the best way for us to keep the game manageable. And we're kind of buying into that now. We're getting comfortable in our rotations. And the biggest thing out of it is you have to rebound. So I think the last couple games we've done a better job of figuring out how to rebound in that. But it really makes a team game plan differently. And shooters on the other team get a little more uncomfortable trying to figure out what's a good shot and what's not a good shot, and they're not used to playing against that defense, and they don't get to run their normal offense. And so I think we've been aided in that a little bit, that the defense has slowed their team's best players down, and really with Grace having the year she's having defensively, it allows us to pressure out in that zone a little more, and she's able to cover up our mistakes. And obviously we have to keep everybody out of foul trouble, and the zone has really helped us do that. So Grace is able to stay on the floor, and if we could get a little more offense from Grace, she'd probably be up there in some talks of, maybe being able to be all conference, because her defense has been pretty good. So, that's probably the next step in her game, is we expect that out of her defensively. Now we need some offense.
Give us a little preview of this upcoming weekend.
Yeah, it'll be, it's another big week. We got Tiffin coming in, who's excellent. I mean, those kids, I feel like, ever since I've been a head coach, I feel like we've been coaching these kids or against these kids. They're a lot of seniors, a lot of kids who've played a lot of minutes. So they're they shoot it well. They're little, but it doesn't seem to hurt them. They're scrappy defensively. They're going to get out and pressure us. They've played Ashland to overtime. They've Ferris. loss to them. That's their only loss. So they're playing all the tough team or the best teams really tough, and it'll be it'll be a tough game for us. It'll be a big challenge. And then Saturday we got Ohio Dominican coming in, and Dominican is has two wins. They're down with I think they just beat Northwood and they beat Grand Valley. So they're going to be a game that on our home floor that we hope to, really play them tough and compete and have a chance to win that game. And I think, they're struggling a little bit with, I believe their coach is out right now and their assistant coach is coaching them. So they're going through some adversity. So it's going to kind of, that game's going to come down to who really wants it and who's able to overcome that adversity the best.
Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.